We're asked to graph the system of equations using the slopes and the y-intercepts. In this video, we will not be focusing on the solution to the system of equations. We'll be reviewing how to graph lines and looking at the three possible outcomes when graphing two lines on the same coordinate plane. Let's first graph the equation y equals negative 2/3 x plus 6. Notice how the equation is in slope-intercept form, which is the form y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. Looking at this equation, notice how the slope m is equal to negative 2/3, which is a ratio of the rise to run, or a ratio of the vertical change to horizontal change, and b is equal to positive 6, which means the y-intercept is your pair 0, 6. Let's first graph this line, so we'll plot the y-intercept 0, 6. Because the slope is negative 2 over positive 3, from the y-intercept we'll go down to right 3, and we can do this multiple times. Down to right 3, down to right 3. The graph of the first linear equation must pass through these four points and look something like this. And now we want to graph the equation 2x minus 3y equals 6. And it does ask to use the slope and y-intercept, and therefore, we'll solve the equation for y and write it in slope-intercept form. So for the first step, we isolate the y term by subtracting 2x on both sides. Simplifying, 2x minus 2x is 0, so we have negative 3y equals. Let's write the right side as negative 2x plus 6, and that is all for y. We divide both sides by negative 3, or divide each term by negative 3. Simplifying, we have y equals, this would be positive 2/3 x, and this would be plus negative 2, or just minus 2. So in this equation, the slope m is equal to positive 2/3, and b is equal to negative 2, which means the y-intercept is 0, -2. Let's go ahead and graph the line. So 0, -2 is the y-intercept. The slope is 2/3, so we'll go up 2, right 3, up 2, right 3, up to right 3, the line passes through these four points and looks something like this. So one possible outcome when graphing two lines on the same coordinate plane is the two lines intersect. So this point of intersection here, given by the ordered pair 6, 2, would be the solution to the system. But we'll formalize that more in our next lesson. Let's take a look at another example of graphing two lines on the same coordinate plane. Again, we're asked to graph the system using slopes and y-intercepts. Looking at the first equation in this system, we have y equals negative x plus 4. We can think of this as y equals negative 1x plus 4 if we wish. So the slope is equal to negative 1, but we do want the slope as a fraction to graph. So let's write negative 1 as negative 1 over positive 1, and b is equal to positive 4, which means the y-intercept is 0, 4. So to graph this first linear equation, we'll plot the y-intercept, 0, 4. From here, we'll use a slope to find additional points. So because the slope is negative 1 over positive 1, we go down 1, right 1. Let's do this multiple times. Down 1, right 1, down 1, right 1, and so on. The first line passes through these points and looks something like this. Now looking at the second equation, we have x plus y equals negative 3. Because we're asked to use the slope and y-intercept, let's solve for y, so we'll subtract x on both sides. Simplify, this would be 0, so we have y equals, let's write the right side as negative x minus 3, if we want negative 1x. So the slope of the second line is also negative 1, or negative 1 over 1. But b is equal to negative 3, so here the y-intercept is 0, -3. Notice how because these lines have the same slope and different y-intercepts, they are going to be parallel. Let's go ahead and graph the second linear equation, plot the y-intercept of 0, -3. Again, the slope is negative 1 over positive 1, so down 1, right 1, down 1, right 1, and so on. The second line passes through these points and looks something like this. So another possible outcome when graphing two lines on the same coordinate plane is the two lines are parallel. When this happens, the system of equations has no solution. Let's look at one more example. Here we're asked to graph the system of equations, but we're not given directions on how to graph. Well, notice how the first equation is in slope-intercept form. The equation is y equals 2x minus 5. So the slope m is equal to 2, or 2 over 1 is a fraction, and b is equal to negative 5, and therefore the y-intercept is the order pair 0, comma, negative 5. So let's go ahead and graph the line. First plot the y-intercept, 0, comma, negative 5. Slope is 2 over 1, so from here we go up 2, right 1. Let's do this multiple times. Up 2, right 1, up 2, right 1, and so on. This is the graph of the first linear equation. And now for the second linear equation, let's find the x and y intercepts since the equation is in general form. Remember, to find the y intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y. To find the x intercept, we set y equal to 0 and solve for x. So beginning with the given equation, 2x minus y equals 5, let's set x equal to 0. We set x equal to 0, we'd have negative y equals 5. Divide both sides by negative 1. Simplifying, we get y equals negative 5. So the y-intercept is the order pair 0, comma, negative 5. And now let's find the x-intercept by setting y equal to 0. So if we set y equal to 0, we'd have the equation 2x equals 5. Divide both sides by 2. We have x equals 5 halves. So the x-intercept is the order pair 5 halves, comma, 0, or 2.5, comma, 0. Let's plot these 2 points and then graph the line. 0, comma, negative 5 is the same y-intercept from the first equation. And then the x-intercept is 5 halves, comma, 0, or 2.5, comma, 0. Notice how this is the same x-intercept as the line from the first equation. So now when we graph the second line, notice how it's the exact same line as the first line. So we say the two lines coincide. When this happens, the system of equations has an infinite number of solutions. So when graphing a system of linear equations on the same coordinate plane, there are 3 possible outcomes. The two lines can intersect at a single point when there's one solution, the two lines can be parallel when there's no solutions, and the two lines can be the same line or coincide. When this occurs, there's an infinite number of solutions. I hope you found this helpful.